I'm Jim Green. I'm the director of planetary science at NASA. When Ridley originally contacted NASA, the public affairs organization put me in contact with them. And I then helped coordinate all the activities and all the people he needed to talk to get exactly the information he needed. I view Mark Watney as one of those top astronauts that we have, you know, a type AAA personality, you know, somebody that can be quite creative, has an in-depth knowledge in certain areas, but also knowledge in other areas that he uses and utilizes. Of course, his knowledge is incredibly important. His background is in botany, and therefore that plays a central role in the movie because he has to be able to figure out a way to grow food and survive on Mars. Mars is not like Earth today. You know, it's a rather severe climate. It's incredibly cold. In one day, the temperature will change more than 120 degrees Fahrenheit. In one day, the highs and the lows. So the hottest it would get is maybe 35 or 40 degrees Fahrenheit. And then it plunges to well below 70 below at night. Those temperature extremes are incredibly difficult to be able to survive without extensive infrastructure. Each of our astronauts have a rigorous program of training that they have to go through. Now, they have certain expertise that they bring with them, but they also have to have some broad knowledge. They also have to have the ability to understand some of the physics in various areas. So Mark is a botanist in the movie. However, he also, as you see in many cases, has to be a chemist, has to be an electrician, has to be a jack of all trades. Mark, when he decides to survive, really has to hack Mars, which means he has to have a deep understanding of the environment and then be able to use it to his advantage. And he does that quite expertly. You know, he brings in the soils. He knows enough about the soils to know he needs to add the fertilizer. He needs to be able to add the associated water. And so he gets those resources together. One of the critical skills that Mark has, and he needs it, is his ability to use math to his advantage, to be able to calculate how much food he needs, how much food he can grow, how much water he needs to be able to create the environment to grow that amount of food, how far things are away, how much power he needs to be able to survive, how much oxygen he needs to be able to create. We do have a team of experts at JPL that are always brought together and at other centers to tackle enormous problems. And using the resources at hand, Apollo 13 is an excellent example of that, where the level of CO2, you know, the outgassing that they produce as they breathe, gets to be so high, and that could actually allow everyone to pass out and die. So you have to scrub that out of the environment. And indeed, they figure out how to do that down at Houston, and they get back to the crew, this is what you need to do. You put these elements together and try that. And they did, and it works. So it's a fabulous connection back to Earth with huge resources and the top minds in the country being able to solve these problems. Andy's book has a lot of fantastic interactions that go on that actually ring very true to me. You know, the personal tensions, the opinions, the things that aren't science that we deal with every day really ring true in a lot of the interactions that Andy portrays in the book.